got an early day from work, so you can see it's sunny. So I thought I'd tackle it. We're gonna get some beds done today. Said I was gonna last time, definitely gonna do it this time. I ain't really done much weeding, because let's face it, I bet most in your aunt. Well, I had a busy Christmas, me two kids, no chance. Well, here I am in nice sunny old Yorkshire. Pretty much can't ask for better conditions. About an hour ago when I was picking wood up, started hammering it down. I don't know if you can see it background. Oh, bright. A lot of my weeds have died down now, so it's a lot more controllable, and I think like I'm ready to go. So what I'm going to do is, I'm just going to tackle it. Right, so I said I got some wood. The car's just been abused on the way home. So, got some special offers on it. I was supposed to be getting this other type, a lot thinner than this size. But it worked out an extra 80 pence per bed it'll cost me. I'm doing 6 foot by 6 foot beds. I'm doing, how many am I doing? Nine-ish. 8 or 9, who's counting? We're gonna tackle them. I've got a good price. I think it was £37 altogether, which works out around, well, your genius, math genius is going to contradict me, but I call everything's in rough on allotment. And it's going to cost me about £6.50 a bed, something like that, £7, which is pretty good price considering how much my last stuff paid, and it's not as thick as this. I spoke to Wood Merchant about this one, and he said it's probably best to get this one. The other one's going to last 1 or 2 years. This one should last at 10 years. Also, nipped over to B&Q. Got myself cell linears, and I got three of them for £1. So I'll be doing my seeds when I get home as well. I don't think I'll bore you with a video on them, because let's face it, it's only putting seeds in dirt. Next week, well, next time I do my update, hopefully we should have some seeds popping through, and I'll be able to do a video on them then. It'll be more interesting. What I'll do is I'm gonna get it all laid out, and then I'll do another quick shot of it, and then hopefully, next time you see it, allotment will look like an allotment and not just like a junkyard. See you in a bit.
Seems like I've done a few videos, but I'm not showing you where I'm doing it. So this is going to be the area. I always forget to do before and after, as you see, so can't really get the idea of it, but I'm going to try and remember today. So it's going to be fun trying to piece all these little videos together and make them into one video for everybody to watch. So, fingers crossed, next time I show you this, there should be something down.
Right, I think we've cracked what we're going to crack. Look how sunny it is again now. You never believe, as soon as I stopped recording, it hammered it down. I got wet through, but I was just carrying on anyway. As you can see, absolutely drenched it down. It's only just stopped. There's sod's law, isn't it? If I'm not stopping now, only chance I've caught. Right, they're in. They're not exactly straight, because I ain't got no string line with me. But they're in best they're going to get put in today. I'm just hoping that no one pinches them. I've got a funny feeling somebody's going to pinch me wood and I'll be gutted. What I've done is I've changed my plans a little bit. I've still got the six large beds I put in, but I've done them different. I've done them as 2 threes instead of, well, I'll show you when I show you that way, because that side is not dug out yet, but this side is. Right, I'll crack on and show you now. Right, here's the view from my gate. As you can see now, we have the six large beds, 6x6, cost about £6.66. Sounds like a riddle, doesn't it? So, and I was originally going to have 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, but this, as you see, that area's not even dug out yet. I might not even tackle that area, but this side's done, so I figured I'd use it. I've got a big, larger gap in the middle, in case I ever need to get down with a wheelbarrow. I don't own a wheelbarrow, but just in case. This is going to be my path, with just some of my old beds, just loosely laid there, just for an example of where they're going to go, but all that area needs to be sorted out. So what we'll do is, I'll walk up, this is going to be my intended path, obviously, to get to the top area. You see, the decent beds, decent wood. I call it an old bed. This is my garlic. Loosely planted, not no weeded. That's where my garlic will last year. So standing at the top of the allotment, I can't really see the screen because it's sun.
You can't see because of my shadow. Six small beds, 6 foot by 3 foot from last year. And then I go on to my new six large beds, 6 foot by 6 foot from this year. Looking at them, I don't even think I'm going to increase depth. I think that's just a good height. I need to get some more soil. But if you're just looking just basically over them edges, it's a big farmer's field, so I'm sure I can go up the wheelbarrow and get as much soil as I need. That's for that area. And I've got these little beds here that are going to be, I don't know, probably, because that's a dead plot. I would like to have fruit there, but I'm just presuming people are just going to pinch fruit edges, fruit fence. My intended plan is for, you can see I've just loosely laid two small beds there. The left end bed's got my rhubarb in it, so I don't really want to be moving that. My rhubarb. And there's one up. It's just starting to crown actually, my rhubarb. I don't know if your guys are crowning. See him? There he is, little fella. So I'm going to be them two beds and then I'm planning on another three beds here. And then possibly that area between the end bed and the fence, looking at some sort of fruit bushes, raspberries and them sort of things, blueberries, because our pound shop sells them. And I'm thinking now, looking at the size of these beds, I could pretty much stop here. And what I wanted to do is, because that's my water source, I wanted to have some sort of L-shaped, nice planter area for flowers, and maybe a little area for kids to play. And then on this side, I'm thinking maybe a seating area, and another useless area, what's not going to be used for anything growing. I don't know, maybe, might not, don't know, not this year, it's not anywhere. So, there we go guys. I've managed to get something done. And now it's starting to look like it's probably supposed to. Right, as usual, thanks for watching. And any comments and questions, feel free to stick them below. And don't forget to subscribe. Thanks a lot, cheers, bye.